Richard Schiff, are you the king of gravitas? If they want to bring gravitas to the show, must you be brought in?
One of my early jobs on Saved by the Bell. That was my job there as well. Yes, absolutely. And I think it worked for that show.
Right.
Yeah. Very deep.
Right. No, but anyway, Ballers is terrific. And this, The Good Doctor, the billboards all over town. Freddie Highmore has been here on many occasions. He's such a good actor. Do you like it?
Yes.
No, he hates
it. No, but you know what? Let's be honest, because everybody's had the circumstance. People have been in things where you were like, I was happy to do it, but it wasn't that great.
Well, it's different for me. Mm-hmm. You know, I've never been on a doctor show before. And this is much more than a doctor show, but the doctor element, I mean, I don't like hospitals.
Right.
And that's my
You're not
set
alone
now.
In that.
Yeah.
That's my set. I don't like hospitals. But there's so much more about the show. You know, Freddie's character, beautifully played. He's a great kid, having to do with autism and so on. And I play a guy who champions that. I have autism in my personal life, and that's one of the reasons that it attracted me to that.
Well, you know, the thing, that phrase autism, of course, covers a spectrum of circumstances.
Keyword spectrum.
Exactly right, because it really is from...
And it doesn't represent, you know, every aspect, every dot on that spectrum creates a very uniquely different human being. So there's no one way to deal with it as a generality. And this particular character has savant syndrome as well, so he's brilliant and also has some difficulties socially connecting and understanding the world. And it presents some really interesting problems to solve.
He is the good doctor, and you're gonna see a clip here where you're essentially advocating that he be allowed to practice. Watch.
I met Sean Murphy when he was 14 years old. I was living in Wyoming at the time. He was, and he still is, an extraordinary young man. Yes, he is autistic. Yes, he has autism, but he also has savant syndrome. Genius level skills in several areas. He has almost perfect recall. He has spatial intelligence, and he sees things and analyzes things in ways that are just remarkable, in ways that we can't even begin to understand. Those are assets, those are benefits. Undeniable assets for any doctor.
Mm. That's a good a speech like that, a scene like that. Does that take you a long time? Are you back at home saying that 20 times over?
I still haven't learned those lines. No, it doesn't anymore because of the years of the West Wing.
Sure.
Allison Janney gave me a trick many years ago. It's not really a trick. It's just a tool to learn lines quickly. And then that muscle gets it's a riding a bike.
What was her trick?
It's a little hard to explain, but it's writing out the first letter of every word in a, like say a paragraph. Right. Take away all the punctuation, and just write the don't take away the punctuation. Just write the right. You know, so if it's don't, you would write D apostrophe T, but then the first letter shows you patterns, especially if it's Aaron Sorkin, because he writes in poetry.
Kids, yeah.
You see alliteration, and so it just kind of. It's a different way in, so to speak, and it's hard to explain, but it works.
No,
that's what you use for you would use for Shakespeare because you see all the patterns in the language and so on. But it's really repetition, and I always get somebody to run lines with, and that's helpful.
There it is. You can see the results of all that. The Good Doctor will premiere next Monday, September 25th at 10 on ABC. Richard, good to see you as always.
A pleasure.
Thank you, Richard.
Thanks.